Good morning, students. Yesterday we had a good class where I started the measurement of an angle and I taught you degree measurement. Under the degree measurement, I taught you degree, minutes and seconds. Today we will study the new measurement of an angle, which is called a radian measurement. Look at what I am telling you. Radian measurement. So, with the circle, I will tell you something. This is a circle. This is a circle. This is center. This is radius. Suppose one more radius is forming here, and between them we have an angle theta in degree. Because we know till now what is a degree system, so we will study the radian at the base of the degree. We will not keep separate to the study of the radian from the degree. We will actually study of the radian with joining theta, which is degree. So what is the relation between them? That only I am telling you. It is a radius, it is a theta degree, and this is the length of the arc L. This is the length of the arc L. Now I am simply telling you that the relation between L, theta, arc and radian, that is very important, that theta degree, which is equal to length of arc upon r radian. This is the fundamental rule which you should remember, that this degree, actually I am comparing that how radian or what radian measurement equal to which degree. That time only by the picture, the study of the radian we can create, like theta degree, like this gonna be 120 degree or 130 degree, maybe anything, but theta degree this time equal to length of arc upon r radian. In the sense, when you don't know the length of arc, when you know the radius, if you will divide, whatever the answer we will get, that will be the radian measurement, which is equal to that theta degree. This is an angle, definitely this also will be an angle. This is an angle, definitely this also will be an angle. But the difference is, this is in degree and this answer will be in radian. Now further, what I will teach you, that will be actually very fruitful for you. Look at again the circle. This is a radius. Suppose it is a radius and length of arc is again r. This time I took L, but the feature which I made here, which is the length of arc equal to radius. What I have taken the condition? Length of arc equal to radius. Meaning two radius intersect an arc with equal length of itself. This is arc, suppose it is also arc. So what will be happening here? Theta degree will be, now what a formula, L by r, this time L equal to this, r upon r, L equal to r upon r radian, and very important thing we have got, that theta degree equal to cancellation, one radian we have got. So now someone will ask you that what is the value of one radian? You can speak freely that this time this theta angle will be called one radian. All can see in first sight that theta degree is equal to 1 radian. What is the value of 1 radian? This will be in degree, but this time it is an acute angle. Right now we do not know what is its value. It may be 50, it may be 60, it may be 45 or something like that. I don't know right now, but later it will be a good question that what is the value of 1 radian, I will tell you. But keep in mind that whatever the theta degree is appearing here, which is something like an acute angle, this is a value of 1 radian. So when 1 radian will create? When 2 radius will intersect arc at the circumference with equal radius, equal length, then only at the center the theta degree will be called 1 radian. So now further, I will tell you one important concept, that this was a circle. Now this is a radius. I took here the radius, then I took the radius, I made obtuse angle and I created this concept. this time I took this r equal to that r equal to that length of arc, and I created this concept. Now I'm taking radius right here, meaning one radius is there and second radius is there. So this gonna be your length of arc, which is L, and this is the centered angle. That this time it was theta, this time it was theta, this is also theta. But very good thing which I want to tell you, that this time you know the value of L as well as you know the value of theta. This time L is none else but it is half of the circumference. It is half of the circumference. You know the circumference value is 2 pi r. The half of 2 pi r is pi r, which is the meaning of L, length of arc. And one more thing which is very easy to tell you, that this is a theta, centered angle, this is 180 degree. So in degree, we know the value of that centered angle. This time we did not know what is theta. This time we did not know what is theta. But this time we know it is a 180 degree. Now again I will use the same law, that what is theta degree equal to L upon R radian. Now put up the value theta degree equal to 180 degree. That is L meaning length of arc, meaning pi r, upon r radian. And very important concept we have got, that r and cancel. Now it gonna be pi radian equal to 180 degree. It is one of the basic fundamental formula, which is actually one of the finest formula for the further study. So pi radian equal to 180 degree, or 180 degree equal to pi radian. So you are familiar with the pi. Pi is actually 22 by 7 or 3.14 approximately. So this radian will be called 180 degree. This radian will be called 180 degree, and this will be the formula by which you can convert to degree in the radian. You can convert to radian into the degree. So that only I will tell you. So further in this, for the next board, I will use this formula and I will prove or derive some special values which you want to know, which you should know. Look at, I tell you. This I am running now. You can see often because the video is with you. Now I was discussing here that what is the value of one radian. You know that when two radius intersect, the length of arc of an equal length, L equal to r, then theta will be called one radian. One radian. So now I want to show, or I want to tell you, that what is the theta in degree in the case of one radian. So that only the way I am telling you, this one you should know actually. Look at the concept we have. We know after this we know pi radian equal to 180 degree. Now you would know it very well. I'm writing that, so pi radian equal to 180 degree. So can I write this pi into 1 radian? It is very simple. One should know that it can be written. Pi into 1 radian equal to definitely pi. So 1 radian equal to what will come? So 1 radian equal to 180 upon pi degree. It's gonna be degree now. I want to find the value of 1 radian, and this will give the idea how we can find the value of 1 radian. This is very simple. Now 1 radian equal to this. Now I want to find actual value of 1 radian, which is 180 upon pi. So pi will be 22 by 7 degree. Now quickly you can write 180 into 7 upon 22. I did reciprocal that. I want to cancel by 2, 2 9s and 2 11. It is 6 30 upon 11. And remind or recall the yesterday's lecture when I taught you that this is in fraction with degree. I will simplify that and I will get my answer in minute and second, so that I could know the value of 1 radian exactly in the degree format. So now I will divide to 630 by 11, and I will now split in a minute and then go in depth. second also. Okay, so I just want to divide it. 11 5s are 55, this is 8 and 0. 11 7s are 77, remainder is a 3 upon 11, this is degree. One should show that 57 plus, this may be written 57 plus 3 by 11 degree, and one should assure that it is complete degree and it is a partial part in degree. Now this is the part of answer, but this is the degree which is in fraction, so I will multiply by 60 and then I will convert in a minute. This yesterday I told you, whenever you want to turn to degree in minute, you have to do just multiply by 60. And then after what I'm getting, 57, I'll multiply it, is gonna be 180 upon 11, this is minute, and same procedure I will use. Then I'll divide, 11 1's are 11, it's 7 remainder 0, 11 6 are 66, definitely 4 is remainder. Now I'll split the same, at 16 plus 4 by 11 in minute. So this may be written 16 minute and 4 by 11 minute. Now again, this is a complete minute, but this is a partial minute. So I'll change in second now. I'll multiply by 60. This is now seconds. And then after 157 degrees, 16 minute. This 2 will be 240 upon 11 whole second. And you know that 240 is not exactly divisible by 11, so just we have to leave in the answer in a approximate format. So only I will divide. 11 2s are 22, 11 1s are 11, 11 8s are 88, and furthermore may possible it will never end. So this is approximate answer in second. Combine all, guys, 1 radian. You are getting 1 radian from here. You will get 57 degree, 16 minute, 21.8 second approximately. This is the exact value of 1 radian. Now, just go in initial part. What was the concept of 1 radian? This is radius in equal length r it is. And I taught you that time this theta degree is gonna be 1 radian. And what is the value of theta degree? Which is 57 degree, something like that. So this is seems, actually it is 57. It seems 57. It is acute angle. I told already that it's gonna be acute angle. It may be 50, something like that. This is 57 degree, 16 minute and 21.8 second. This question is important as far as exam is concerned. So maybe ask in a question that find the value of 1 radian, you have to go through this. Okay, so let me wrap this. But what the formula you have read, it is one of the important formula, and I will tell you that why it is important. Look at, I tell you, this is the formula you read, that pi radian equal to 180 degree. That is the finest formula. Because with this formula, you can change to all the degree in radian. You can change to all the radian in degree. So few example I want to take. Suppose you are told, find the radian measurement of 240 degree. So you will use the formula. So what the formula you will use? Look at. Since 180 degree equal to pi radian, so 240 degree equal to what radian? That is very simple concept. It's called a unitary method. So you will just multiply these two and divide by 180. So you will write 240 pi radian upon 180, and by cancellation of 6 4s are 6 3s and pi, this is the answer of 240 degree equal to 4 pi by 3 radian. So hope slightly you are getting that how we can find the answer. By this formula, you can get all the radian measurement of all the angles. So just opposite question I want to take. Find the degree measurement of 3 pi by 2. Suppose this is a question. This is a question. Now what is the degree measure of 3 pi by 2? So you write the same formula, but this time write opposite. Like, we know pi radian equal to 180 degree. This time I wrote 180 degree equal to pi radian. You can understand that degree we had given and we wanted its radian value. This time radian is given and we want its a degree system. So pi radian equal to 180 degree and 3 pi by 2 radian equal to, you multiply and divide, 180 into 3 pi by 2 divide by pi, this multiply this and divide by pi, pi and pi cancel, 270 degree equal to this radian you got. So this is only a simple concept. By the unitary method you can get your answer. Let me tell you the short way, and this you have to use now in further working. So don't do like that. This is the complete concept. But I tell you the simple and shortest concept, that whenever you are given, again look the board, suppose you are given a 240 degree and you want its radian concept. You want its radian form. So only I'm telling you the trick, that whenever you are given the degree format and you want to find its radian concept, you only do multiply by pi by 180 in shortest concept and you write only radian. It is your answer. Shortest way. Whenever the degree is given, you want your answer radian, you multiply by pi by 180 and don't write whatever I taught you here. Since this and this and so on, please don't write. This is a short trick and you use only in a question. 6 cancel by 6, 6 4s are 6 3s and this is answer of 240 degree. This is a 240 degree. Okay, now one more question I want to say. Suppose you are given here 315 degree and you want to turn the radian. So what you are going to do? You are going to do 315 into pi by 180 and right here it is a radian. It is a 350 degree and you are turning in a radian. Now answer is, you can cancel by whatever the possibilities they are and whatever the answer, it is in radian. The symbol of radian, just like C, if you are writing in the power C, it is meaning radian. It somewhere it is written, don't get confused, it is a radian actually. So this is the method. Whenever the degree is given, you want to convert that in a radian. So you only multiply by pi by 180 and just opposite. Suppose you are given radian and you want its a degree format. What you're going to do? You just have to multiply by 180 by pi. Meaning, this is a radian form. This is a radian form. You want to turn in a degree. You multiply by 180 by pi. And right here, the degree. Now, radian will not be written because you have change in degree. Now, cancel by pi and pi. 4, 45, 3 is 135. This is answer in degree. So, hope you have got. Whenever radian is given, you want to change in degree, multiply by 180 by pi. And whenever the degree is given, you want to change in radian, multiply by pi by 180. And it will be your answer. So, this was only the concept which I wanted to share with you. So look once or two questions from the exercise examples so that we can start the concept. Examples. Example number one, I'm telling you, convert 40 degree 20 minutes in radian. Look at the thing which I want to share with you. This is 40 degree 20 minute. And you want to turn in radian. As I recently taught you that whenever you want to turn in radian, you have to multiply by pi by 180. But concern one thing, that this should be in degree. It should complete in degree, but unfortunately it is not complete in degree. It is degree, but it is actually minute. So you have to convert first that whole in a degree. So yesterday I taught you that very simple. This is 40 degree 20 minute. This was in minute, so turn in degree. How to do? 20 by 60. This is a way to turn Latin degree from the minute. Just divide by 60. And this is going to be now degree. Now do it. 40 degree cancel by 20. It is degree. Combine that. It is degree. And this is going to be 121 by 3. LCM and answer. This is degree. This is not the answer. Now you want to turn in a radian. So what you're going to do? 121 by 3 degree. You want to turn in a radian. What you're going to do? Multiply by pi by 180. And this is going to be your radian. This is only things which I wanted to share with you. This was actually given. Not complete in degree, but degree in minute. So I turn, as I told you the method. And this was complete degree now. You can change by this. The cancellation is not possible. So only write your answer. 18, 3 is a 54, 540. And this is the answer in radian. This is complete answer. So okay, this is enough for the day. I taught you today a very important concept. You can do the practice now. From the exercise, you can start 3.1 exercise. And initially, I am giving you question number 1, all 4 questions. And question number 2, last 2 questions. Third and 4. Question number 1, all questions. And question number 2, third and 4. This is your working. Please do. Thank you.